This video was brought to you by GeneralPack.com, making power systems intuitive, open, and free to everyone, everywhere. Consider subscribing and supporting through patreon.com/generalpack. This is the mechanism for you to support us financially so we can continue making high-quality power system video tutorials. Our corporate sponsor for this topic is AllumiaX.com from Seattle, Washington. Contact them for industrial and commercial power system studies.
Types of protective relays and design requirements, part 2D. This is the fourth part of topic 2 in the series of types of relays. In this part, we will be discussing the next two types of relays that are the differential relays and the time delay relays. Now, the fifth type of relay we would be discussing here in this part is a differential relay. A differential relay is one that operates when the phasor difference of two or more similar electrical quantities exceed a predetermined value. And to explain this a little bit further, the relay would operate a protective device or a circuit breaker, for example, right? When we say phasor, we're talking about a magnitude difference or an angle difference, or both magnitude and angle. So a phasor difference of two or more similar electrical quantities that exceed a predetermined value, a set point, or some settings, right, of those two quantities. So those two phasor quantities could be current, they could be voltage, they could be angle, and so forth. So how the mechanism works for a differential relay is this. A current differential relay is one that compares the current entering a section of the system with the current leaving the section. And under normal operating conditions, the two currents are equal, but as soon as a fault occurs, this condition no longer applies. And the difference between the incoming and outgoing current is arranged to flow through the operating coil of the relay. If this differential current is equal to or greater than the pickup value or the set point, then the relay will operate and open the circuit breaker to isolate the faulty section. Some of the applications for a current differential relay is to protect large power transformers for the protection of generators or for the protection of motors against faults and short circuits. Another application is protection of feeder or transmission lines by pilot wire differential protection, or in other words, communication assisted differential protection. Another application is bus bar protection or bus differential protection. Now, the next type of relay are time delay relays. The time delay circuit contains an electromechanical relay and driver circuit, and this circuit decides the time delay to give a power supply so the electromechanical relay coil can be energized through the relay. Now, in the working mechanism, there is a resistor as shown. A resistor R1 and a potentiometer and R2 are connected in series with a 12-volt DC input supply. And the other end of the potentiometer is connected to a capacitor and a Zener diode that is reverse bias. We can use this circuit to turn on or turn off some sensitive time delay required electrical applications. Now, moving on to the applications of time delay relays. Some are like industrial control systems needing timed operation. Time delays are used to provide desired time delay and timing functions. Now, that is all for today's part, and in the next part, part 2E, we will continue our discussion on the two remaining types of relays. We hope that you have a continued interest in this topic as a student or professional. We also hope that you find this content useful and enlightening. Please consider subscribing to GeneralPack.com or becoming a patron at patreon.com/GeneralPack. GeneralPack.com, making power systems intuitive, open, and free to everyone, everywhere.